Hi guys, if you're new to my channel, then subscribe my YouTube channel Kala Style. Select the bell icon to get latest updates. Thank you. Hi and hello viewers, welcome back to Kala Style. In this video, we'll see how to make one of my favorite snack, which is curd muruku. In Tamil we call it as Thair Muruku, in Telugu they call it as Perugu Janthikalu. It is one of traditional dish. This recipe will gonna be very helpful for the beginners in cooking. Come on, let me see the procedure. This recipe is going to do by my mom. Take a white bowl like this, add butter. I'm using 50 grams of homemade saltless butter. Now add 2 teaspoons of red chili powder, or you can adjust according to your spiciness. Salt according to your taste. Here my mother is using approximately 1 heaped teaspoon of salt. With help of your hands, mix all these 3 ingredients nicely until all the 3 things get mixed very well. I have learned this recipe from my family friend Amruta Aunty. I'm feeling very thankful to her. Perugu Janthikulu is a tangy muruku made using sour curd as a main ingredient. Now add exactly 1/2 liter of salt thick curd. Ensure to not use fresh curd in this recipe. Keep the fresh curd in room temperature for 3 days so that it turns to nice salt curd, because it is the main ingredient for this recipe. Mix this paste very well for at least 5 to 7 minutes. Make sure to not form any lumps. Usually we buy this muruku in shops. After I tried this recipe, it came out amazingly. It was very tasty. I was very much excited. If you are using ready-made or salt butter from the shop, adjust the level of salt. Now you can see all the 4 ingredients got mixed very well. Now add 1/2 kg of rice flour. You can use ready-made rice flour or homemade rice flour. If you are using homemade rice flour, ensure to not soak the raw rice in water. Just take a raw rice and turn to fine powder in mill shop. Now mix the flour very well, like how we prepare the dough for normal muruku. Knead this mix very well. The dough should not be very thick. Meanwhile, heat oil in the kadai for deep fry. The dough should hold the shape like this. Make sure to not add any amount of water for this recipe. After kneading this dough, ensure this mix should not sticky to your hand. So this is the right consistency and ready to make muruku. Use 3-eyed disc thick round sieve in the muruku maker. Fill the dough in it. Carefully press the dough into the hot oil directly in a circular motion. Do this process carefully. Deep fry over the medium flame until the muruku turn golden brown in color and the bubbles subside in the oil. Fry this muruku on both the sides. As you can see, there is very less bubbles when compared to before. So muruku is ready to remove from the hot kadai. Drain excess oil onto the kitchen napkin, or you can place this muruku in a colander for a while. Our golden brown tasty crunchy curd muruku is ready right now. Let all the muruku come down to room temperature. Later store it in a airtight container. I hope you will try this recipe and don't forget to share your feedback below. If you like this recipe, just give thumbs up button and don't forget to subscribe my channel. Bye.